Next up, we have Mo Bradbury of the Bradbury Brotherhood.
Bradbury Productions?
Yeah, Bradbury Productions. Mo Bradbury is being charged with serial cringer on probation from YouTube and prank fraud of the first degree. Here we go. Mo Bradbury. I don't know why I have to refresh it every time or it never works.
What's going on, man? Just check real quick.
Mo has a real broccoli assassin.
It's $1.20.
Oh, you got 50 cents, man.
50 cents?
Yeah.
You know what? Give me that. Take your 50 cents. I'll let you slide this time. Take your apples and get out of here.
Yo, why you did that, bro? What's good with you?
You only give me 50 cents. It's $1.20. Keep it grooving.
Okay, so this prank misses on so many levels. I think Mo thought he was going to look like badass. The description is, sorry, dude, you get what you pay for. Here's the thing. He's buying apples. The poor guy's, like, starving. He's buying two apples. He's like, I only got 50 cents. Like, he's homeless. Hey, fuck you. I'm going to eat your apples. Obviously, Mo doesn't work at a grocery store. Yeah. Or that'd be wild. Maybe they did fall from grace that hard. But it's obviously fake.
Uh-huh.
He almost ate the sticker, by the way. What are your thoughts? Did he look badass here?
No, not badass. Almost at first when he was going to be like, okay, you can go. But did he think that was going to be funny or what?
Yeah, I think it was supposed to be funny and badass. But I think this kid just seems like pathetic and desperate for a couple apples. You know what I mean? So, missed the mark for me.
Yeah.
That's that. Mo Bradbury stealing cookies prank. Oh, yeah. This one's fantastic. Got to refresh.
Make sure you have a recording at all times, all right?
Man, how you doing?
I'm doing all right. These are the cookies.
How could I help you?
Yeah, how much are these?
These?
Yeah.
Check the prices on it, man. Look around it.
Yeah. All right, thank you.
Hey, where you going?
Yo, are these cookies?
Yo, where you going with that shit?
Wait, I wanted to show him the cookies.
Oh, why didn't you tell me that, man?
No, it's just like...
You told me fucking cookies, man, but you can't run like that.
Make sure you have a recording at all times, alright?
Bailiff? So the prank is that... It's really nonsense. I mean, it truly doesn't make sense. He's running out to show it to his friend. Why is he running out of the store? The implication, of course. AI Ian, can you help me make sense of this?
I mean, well, first of all, first the Kobe thing and then Mo, we're really comparing apples and oranges here. What sort of cartoon courtroom is this?
What is your point? I don't get it.
Kobe with the oranges, Mo with the apples.
Oh, it's fruity?
Is this are we running a supermarket? What is this? What do you get at, huh?
Okay, noted. Ben, interesting.
Also, you guys have him charged as a... for pranks, would you call the Apple video a prank?
I would call the second one a prank. I would call the first one a
cringe.
Yeah, I don't even know what the hell you call that.
No, I think
it's a prank,
actually,
bro.
Well, Mo speaks just for himself. Go ahead, Mo, one more time. Mo?
It's a prank, bro.
AIN?
Look, I've got real evidence here. Mo was actually just being educational. I knew this scenario looked familiar, and I had to refer to an old elementary school textbook widely circulated throughout the United States. I had a feeling Mo was onto something here, demonstrating to the children. And let me show you an excerpt from that textbook. I've got a page right here. If Mo has two apples for $1.20 and Joe has 50 cents, how many apples does Joe get? The answer, two apples minus five bites. This is taught in schools. This is canon.
Canon. This is human canon.
Human canon. Curriculum in elementary schools as we speak.
Wow.
Hmm.
That's some legit evidence right there.
If Mo has two apples, he gets it for 50 cents. Well, I guess fair is fair in that regard.
Don't you remember this old wow. problem?
I don't remember this.
They teach you about Mo?
I do know that you're not human, so I wonder where you're dipping your experience from. But regardless, it is a fascinating piece of evidence that I will consider. Thank you. AB, how do you refute that?
Well, first of all, the validity of that I don't believe is true, being that part of the guy's head was cut off in the photo. But also following the premise, it doesn't make sense because, okay, he only has half the money, so he should get one of the apples rather than two. But instead, he just took a bite out of both of them. Right. So the premise doesn't make sense. And in referring to fake pranks, if you watch the video again at the end, you could see a reflection of Flash in the guy in the clerk's eyes when he chases him outside. And he doesn't even acknowledge the camera, even after he's told that essentially it's a prank.
He's in on it.
Forget about it.
You know, I have one more thing to say.
Proceed.
You know, a man is more than
why
the
does the robot clear its throat, Ayan? I always wonder that.
I'm processing.
Oh, okay.
It's the buffer.
a man is more than the sum of his parts. You're trying to make a mixed berry pie with only one berry. The Bradberries are like a Voltron of rawness. To judge just one half of the berry is inconclusive.
Mm-hmm.
Where is the raw god?
Fair point.
Where is he? I call this an inconclusive mistrial.
Well, I actually think AI Ian has a rather good point. And the reason... he's, of course, referring to Ethan Bradbury, Moe's brother. And we excluded him because his pranks are, as they say, lit. Right.
And what way?
Would you like to submit that? One to the to
really
for consideration, AI Ian?
Well, I mean, are we going to judge art now in here? High art?
No, that is not the objective of this court.
Cheers!
All righty. Thank you, everyone, for your arguments. We will deliberate now. Mo Bradbury, serial cringe and prank fraud in the first degree. Well, I feel like AB made a really persuasive argument about the prank fraud. I feel like it has to be fake. Both of them.
They are most definitely fake. Is he even trying to hide it is my question.
Yes, of course.
He is?
Of course.
Oh.
Obviously. Yes. And on cringe, Hila, how do you find?
Cringe, I've seen worse.
Seen worse. Cringe. The apple thing.
Was this
thing,
made now?
Yeah, they're recent.
Yeah? The one was wearing a mask, too?
When were they shot, AB?
What's going on here?
Yeah, that's in New York, too. They're not fucking around over there.
Okay, so one was December. The one in the store was December 2019.
Oh, okay. That's pre-pandemic.
Yeah.
Okay, that makes sense.
The other one is also December 2019.
So we've got the apple-biting prank, where he's trying to act like a tough guy, and the more he steals the cookies, you don't think they're that bad. You've seen worse.
Kind of.
Mo Bradbury, on the charge of serial cringe on probation from YouTube, we find the defendant not guilty. Prank fraud in the first degree, we find Mo Bradbury guilty as charged. Although the court does add consideration
for
the...
It's a prank, bro!
Yes. The court does add consideration to the fact that Mo Bradbury is a mere seed of himself without the greater Ethan Bradbury, so as AI Ian pointed out. And so we are putting him on probation, and he is charged to keep doing his thing and keeping it raw and keeping it regular.